Link TV, connecting you to the world. Link TV is viewer supported. Watch more at linktv.org.
أسد الصحراء,
Lion of the Desert, and the Sheikh of the Mujahideen are titles that were associated with a national leader who fought colonization forces from atop the saddle of his horse. Omar al-Mukhtar is today's figure in a report from our colleague Basil al-Aridi.
كان هذا الرجل في الخمسين من عمره عندما أسس حركة المقاومة في ليبيا ضد الاحتلال.
Omar al-Mukhtar was in his 50s when he founded the resistance movement in Libya against the Italian occupation. He waged some of the greatest battles in the history of Libyan jihad. The most remarkable one was the Battle of Friday in Darana, in which 10 Italian military officers and 60 soldiers were killed, and 400 were reported injured or missing. The Italians withdrew in a state of chaos, leaving behind their weapons, food, and ammunition. However, this was only the beginning. In the early 20th century, he joined the masses of the Mujahideen in the Italian-Libyan wars in Sudan and Chad. This man has long been seen by the Arabs, especially the Libyans, as a role model. The Emir of Poets, Ahmed Shawki, eulogized him in one of his greatest poems. The great late Syrian producer, Mustafa al-Akkad, made a documentary film about his life, starring Anthony Quinn.
عمر المختار درس اللغة العربية والعلوم التشريعية وحفظ القرآن وعلى الرغم من
He had many titles, but his name remained Omar al-Mukhtar. He studied Arabic literature and the science of religion and memorized the Quran. Despite his religious upbringing and his desire to follow a religious path, the invasion and occupation did not give him a chance to do so. After the fascist coup d'etat in Italy, the situation in Libya changed. As pressures intensified on Mohamed Idriss Senussi, he was forced to leave the country, leaving Omar al-Mukhtar in charge of political and military affairs and his brother Rida in charge of religious affairs. After the abolition of the Libyan-Italian accords due to the Italian attack on Tripoli, colonization forces began marching to Green Mountain, where the resistance fighters were gathering and preparing for combat. The residents supported them financially, morally, and militarily. After a series of failed military campaigns and hefty losses, Mussolini ordered a change in the military leadership. The new leadership started deceptive peace talks with Omar al-Mukhtar in order to buy time and fortify their military positions. After the Lion of the Desert rejected an offer to give up jihad and go to Hijaz or Egypt in exchange for monetary compensation, General Graziani, one of the most brutal and bloodiest military leaders, was appointed to be in command. Graziani set up gallows, built prisons, and besieged the fighters at Green Mountain. In 1931, an Italian military fleet managed to track down al-Mukhtar. They then called for reinforcements and waged a battle which resulted in the arrest of the Sheikh of the Mujahideen. He was transported to Benghazi by sea, out of fear that the rebels would carry out rescue missions for him. In September 1931, an hour-long sham trial was held and he was sentenced to death by hanging. The execution took place amid heavy security and military measures and the presence of 20,000 residents. The military warplanes hovered loudly over the area in order to prevent Mukhtar from addressing the people.
إلا أن كلماته الأخيرة على حبل المشنقة خرقت الإجراءات التعسفية.
However, his last words still came out despite these arbitrary measures. We do not surrender, we triumph or die. This is not the end. The next generation and the generation that follows will fight on. As for me, my life will last longer than my executors.
This program is brought to you by Link TV for educational and non-commercial use only. Link TV is the only U.S. network dedicated to global and national news, uncompromising documentaries, and diverse cultural programs, programs which connect you to the world.